Salamander breeder Uwe Seidel has cherished this passion for more than 40 years. In his cellar, he cares for and breeds countless fire salamanders of about a dozen subspecies. Among them are the native ones. This is Salamandra salamandra salamandra, and the other is Salamandra salamandra terrestris. One animal is more spotted and the other has interrupted stripes. So these are two different subspecies that occur in Germany. Most of Germany is inhabited by the striped subspecies. The spotted salamander lives in Bavaria. Their skin is beautiful, but also very sensitive. The danger of infection by fungi, bacteria, and viruses is great, so hygiene and balanced moisture are the be-all and end-all. Because they are amphibians, people think that they have to be kept especially wet. But exactly the opposite is the case. Fire salamanders regulate their moisture independently, which means you must not keep them wet, but you must give them the opportunity to control the moisture of their skin themselves. That's the secret. For better hygiene, Seidel has developed a systematic care system, stackable boxes. Even the interior works according to the modular principle. A wet box with peat for digging, a bathing basin with an exit, a dry hiding place under rocks, and newspaper as substrate. It doesn't have to be pretty, but functional. You have to imagine one thing. Newspaper is paper, paper is cellulose, and cellulose is also exactly what salamanders move on in the wild, on dead leaves. That's cellulose. So it's just cellulose in a slightly different form. Systematic care also helps Uwe Seidel to limit the efforts of rearing larvae. A flow-through system provides freshly filtered water. The salamander larvae stay in these tanks for 6 to 8 weeks, until shortly before metamorphosis. Here we have the first juveniles that have come ashore on this swimming island. And we are now transferring them into a so-called post-metamorphosis box. After about 10 to 14 days, the metamorphosis is complete and the small fire salamanders are placed in such a box in small groups of 5 to 6. The animals remain in the box for the next 5 to 6 months. After this time, the salamanders are separated. That means they continue their development in a single box, like this one. And here we have a small salamander from last year. Uwe Seidel devotes 3 to 4 hours a day to his animals. What started as a hobby has become real conservation breeding, and others now benefit from his expert knowledge gathered over decades. What we are doing at the moment is simply buying time. We don't want to let the animals die out and hope for an opportunity in the future that science might get to grips with these problems after all. Until then, Uwe Seidel's boxes are Noah's Ark for the fire salamanders, threatened by the deadly fungus.